I'm Evelyn and welcome to my channel. I hope you're all having a wonderful day. So today we are continuing with my Redwood Lane build that I did, or I showed the exterior of it on, was it Sunday? Yes, I think so. So today we're continuing with just the interior. I am doing a little bit on like, there are two terraces and also the back porch as well, but other than that, we're basically just doing the interior. So if you guys like interior, or if you like my interiors, this is probably the video for you. So yeah, I hope you guys like this. The kind of style that I ended up going for was a mix of mainly like rustic, kind of a lot of plants with a little bit bohemian as well, ergo the plants, because someone commented, it was one of the first comments I got, or one of the first suggestions for the interiors I got was like rustic, bohemian, kind of. So I made it mainly rustic, but there are definitely a couple of more bohemian touches now and then throughout the build. So that was a lot of fun to do. Not a style that I would usually go for in for houses. Apartments, sure, done bohemian several times. It's one of my favorite styles to do interiors in for apartments, but not houses, because for some reason I never feel like the houses that I build kind of suit a more bohemian kind of style, you know what I mean? So it was fun to just try to put a little bit of a touch here and there, now and then throughout the build, a little bohemian touch. So yeah, I hope you guys like this. It's very warm, it's very brown, it's very red. There are some yellow now and then as well, so it's a typical kind of me interior, I would say, but then again, with the bohemian touches now and then. But personally, I like it. It may not be everyone's cup of tea, but personally, I like this kind of style. It was fun to do. So yeah, the family that lives here, I ended up going for the parents' bedroom. There's room for two parents, the one teen, two kids, if I recall correctly, one toddler, and then there's like a guest house, either a guest house or it's an extra kind of house for a young adult of some sort, maybe a bit of an older teen that lives over there, although they have their own kitchen as well. So I mean, probably more like a young adult that still lives at home in my opinion, or that guest house that I was talking about before. The only thing is we can't really invite guests over and then have them sleep in a house for themselves, you know. They can't really come over for, let's say, a couple days straight and then, you know, sleep in the house. So it doesn't really work like that. So I decided that I would just, or I decided to just pretend like it's for a young adult basically. So yes, they have their own little space over there. There is no living area in that little house, but there is a kitchen, like I said, a dining area, and they also have their own computer there. So basically they can sit over there. Maybe it's a young adult that's struggling to become like a famous writer or something. I did think of a little bit of a story for this family because I just felt like they needed one, kind of. So yeah, basically either one of the parents is a famous artist, so that's kind of how they could afford this house. The other one does furniture, and that's why there is a woodworking table in the backyard. And yeah, I think it's the mom. I decided to be a painter. I don't know, I could just see her paint. I don't freaking know. It was the terrace. When I got to the terrace, I was like, this is a painting area. But yeah, so basically what's going on, because there's a little bit of a story with the teen as well. The teen doesn't want to live where they live because they kind of live on the countryside a little bit, you know. They have the well, country, coastal country, kind of, is that a thing? I don't fully know. But they live away from the city, obviously. But the teen wants to move to Samishino when she becomes old enough, because she really wants to be a musician. So you'll see in her room, I both put a keyboard. She has a very small room, by the way, but she also has her own terrace area, which is in one of the turrets, as you can see from the front. There's a turret on the left side. There's a little bit of like a, like an outdoorsy area that your Sims can actually get to in that turret. So that's her little cozy area. But in her room, she has a keyboard and also a guitar. I think just one guitar. And then in the turret on the terrace kind of area outside, she's got two easels because she's also an amazing painter, just like her mom. But she's also got two guitars, or three, I don't fully remember. And there's also like a couch situation. So yeah, she's really a talented painter too, but she really wants to do music. So she wants to move to Samishino once she becomes a young adult and chase her dreams. Or, because I felt like it would kind of fit with Get Famous a little bit, but the thing is, I don't personally. I think I would struggle big time to do starter homes in Del Sol Valley because the lots are so big. Unless you build in the city area, in the, what's it called? I don't fully remember, but the stars, the boulevard kind of thing. So unless you build in that area, because there's like a 20 by 20, possibly also a 30 by 20 or something like that. So smaller lots, but in the other areas, the lots are a lot bigger. And I struggle doing starter homes as it is because I want to decorate everything, and you just can't do that with starter homes because you don't have the budget to do that. So I personally feel like starter homes are not really, Del Sol Valley is not starter home friendly. So maybe in my mind, at least, it would make more sense if you move a sim, if you want, really want a sim to start out with Get Famous, like with the whole celebrity system, it would make more sense to move them to Sammashino, because I've seen a few theories around, like surrounding this, but it feels like Sammashino might be a little bit of an extension of Del Sol Valley or the other way around. So personally, I think Sammashino is probably more like a starter point, and then once you got the money, you can move into a smaller house that is in Del Sol Valley. So in my mind, the teen would move to Sammashino to start out, and then, you know, eventually she could move to Mirage Park, and then hopefully one day she'll be famous and she would be living in the Pinnacles. But she definitely does not want to live here in the countryside by the water. It is just too, what's called, secluded, is that what it's called? Isolated from the rest of the city. So she wants to move to something a little bit more busy, surrounded with more people, and just live that city life basically. So yeah, I don't know about the young adult living in the separate house, like in the guest house situation. I don't know if they're just not interested in moving anywhere else, or if they are struggling a little bit. I mean, their room is pretty nice, so it's not like, it doesn't look like they're struggling. However, you know, the parents are also kind of rich because they got this huge house, so they have to be rich. So I don't know if they just struggle a little bit like that, because I figure if your parents are rich like this family is, because it is a family that really cares about each other, so they would probably help a little bit with the, if the young adult really wanted to move out. So maybe the young adult just wants to stay at home in this countryside situation. I keep saying situation when I don't fully know what to say. You guys have probably noticed by now. But yeah, so maybe they just don't want to move away from this area, or maybe they just like to stay with the family or something like that, but still have their own little guest house so they can, you know, have a little bit more privacy. You know, once you get older, you want a little bit more privacy. You don't want to be around your parents all the time, so it's probably nice to have their own little guest room house over there. But I don't fully know. I think they're more like a writer or something like that. I don't picture them to be a painter like the mom. So maybe they help the dad a little bit with furniture. I don't fully know. Maybe they're the gardening type because they do have a big garden in the backyard as well. So I did have to change the greenhouse because one of you guys let me know that those greenhouses don't actually work. So I changed it to something else. I don't think I've included it in the photos at the end of the video in the screenshots. But oh yeah, there is a screenshot at the very, very end of this video where I took the screenshot from the back of the build, so you can see everything in the backyard again, just to make sure that if I change something, or, you know, I'd also put furniture on the terrace and stuff, so you can see that from afar as well on that picture or in that picture. So I did add that one, so if you want to see what the new greenhouse looks like, it'll be shown in that picture. Just thought I would notify you because I was a little bit bummed out that it didn't work, gotta be honest. I thought those little round greenhouses were super cute, but apparently they don't work, so that's a shame. So I had to come up with something else, and I don't know, you can see it like on the left, in the upper left corner right now. It's kind of weird, but it works. I tested it and it works, so that's good at least. Also, today is patch day, and I don't know about you guys, but I'm so freaking excited. Obviously, we're not using any of the new pack or any of the new pack and also patch stuff in this build, because I finished this build yesterday, so Monday, so I didn't have access to anything. But for the next couple builds, there'll definitely be something. I will currently be recording with the new expansion pack as well for some early access stuff tomorrow for you guys. So I hope you guys are excited for that. I will definitely try to build like a bigger house or something like that in the Hollywood Hills. That's what it's called the Pinnacles. So yes, that's what I think I'm gonna do at first. And then after that, possibly build something in Mirage Park because I haven't done that yet. So that'll be exciting too. But yes, today is just gonna be a super exciting day. I'm just so happy today. So I don't feel like I've waited long for this though, because it's just, time has just flown by. Like, yeah, keep yourself busy and time just flies by like crazy. So it's not really been like, I don't feel like I've waited a long time for this. It's just kind of, yeah, time just flew by. So, but I'm super excited to play around with terrain tools as well, because I didn't get to do that at Sims Camp. Not really, because the whole house shell, building a house shell and then trying to shape the ground around the house shell wasn't really working for me, so I didn't really get to test that out properly. But I will be doing that today, so I'm super super excited for that too. It's just gonna be a good day. I'm so happy we're getting terrain tools. I've said this so many times, but I'm just so happy we're getting terrain tools. And I'm so excited to see what everyone else is gonna do with them as well, because oh my god, we have so many creative people in this community, so that's gonna be so freaking good. And yes, I don't know, sorry, I'm so excited. Also, if you do want to see some stuff with early access with a new pack and possibly, yes, also terrain tools, of course, because that's also coming today for everyone. So if you do want to see some stuff with that, tune in again tomorrow at 4 p.m. I am pretty sure that all your sub boxes are gonna go crazy, because there are a lot of people who are getting early access this time. So yes, you'll probably see a lot of videos in your sub boxes with the new pack, and also combined with the new patch today. They'll be up tomorrow around, is it 4 p.m. GMT, so that's UK time. I think that is 8 a.m. PST, if I'm not mistaken. So if you want to see something from me as well, I will be uploading around that time tomorrow as well, so be excited for that. If it's not up at 4 p.m. tomorrow, it'll definitely be up later on in the evening, because I do have a job to fix today, so I will be a little bit delayed possibly, but I'm gonna do my best to have it up in time for 4 p.m. my time. So hopefully, crossing my fingers, that I can get it done in time. Otherwise, it'll be there, you know, later on in the evening, and hopefully also something Thursday. I am so excited. I'm just gonna spend all my time fixing that job quickly, and then just all my time focusing on making videos the next 2 days, like I usually do, to be honest, but it's fine. So that's gonna be really, really good. I am so excited to share stuff with you guys, and it's just, yes, I'm so excited. So just quickly before we move on to the next area of the build, this is the teen's creative space. So the little terrace that I was talking about before in one of the turrets, this is her room. And as you can see, I did put in a lot of musical instruments. I still wish we had like a proper bass and also a drum kit, because I feel like those are missing, but maybe at some point, hopefully that'll happen for us as well. I really want to be able to put together like a proper band. That would be freaking cool. So hopefully one day, but not yet. Unfortunately, we just have guitars and pianos and keyboards, but maybe one day it'll happen for us. Crossing my fingers. But she has her little area out there on the terrace area situation, and also has her easels, because she does like to paint, but she just prefers music over painting. So she wants to be a musician rather than a painter. So yeah, I'm gonna be super excited to make this family as well. Actually, I can't really imagine what they look like so far, but it'll be fun to do that. It'll be fun to make them, I feel like, because they're a little bit different. I feel like they would have a more of like a quirkier kind of, maybe a quirky slash bohemian kind of style, maybe. So that's gonna be fun to do. I decided to give the kids this room rather than the toddler room, even though they are two kids and the toddler is just one toddler, because it just suited the whole, like the whole shape is a little bit better for this room rather than the toddler room that you'll see in a second, because it's round as you can see right now. So I decided to do that, although the kids room is a little bit small, but it suits two children's two kids overall, and they have their toys in there as well. They also have, both have a journal each, which is pretty good for them. They can practice a lot of different traits with those journals, so I'm always up for giving kids and also teens journals in my bills. I just feel like that's a nice thing we got with parenthood right there. So yes, I think I've said that before as well, but it's really good for gameplay, I feel like. So they got their own journal each, and in here I just put a lot of toys for the little toddler, and I was going for more like a ladybug kind of theme in here. Actually, I think I ended up going for more like a greener wall, which kind of reminds me of like country, because with the ladybug and you got the grass green and the red, which is more like ladybug, but at the same time they also like spaceships. So this is just a cute little toddler room. I think it turned out okay. I'm not necessarily, you know, usually super happy with my toddler rooms, but I kind of like this one, to be honest. I did, so hopefully you guys will like it too. So I also gave the toddlers their own little bathroom, actually, just to make sure that they had everything they needed for that, because the toddlers have a little bit of like different needs than a usual sim. So they need a bathtub to be bathed, and they also need a potty to go to pee. So yeah, they got their own little bathroom as well. It's very tiny, so I decided to cut it out, but we are showing this bathroom, and I think there was another one as well, if I'm not mistaken. There is laundry in this house, by the way, so I did put in hampers, is that what they're called? The baskets you put your laundry in, is that called a hamper? I feel like it sounds correct, but at the same time I feel like it sounds wrong. Anyways, so I put those around the house as well, so if you don't want to play with laundry, you can just take out the laundry machines and also the hampers, and you know, that'll be fine. There's nothing outside that requires laundry at all. There is no clothesline or an outdoors laundry bucket thing. So yes, I just thought I would point it out, because I know not everyone likes to play with laundry. I know that some people do, but not everyone does, so it's always nice to give you guys the opportunity to choose whether or not you want to play with it. So I'm trying to get better at remembering to put it in my build, because I feel like it's easier to take out rather than to make room for, if you get what I mean. So I'm trying to get better at remembering to put them in my builds, but it's not always that I do, because personally I'm not a big fan of playing with laundry, so there is that. So yeah. And over here I actually almost forgot to furnish this little guest house, and I noticed it while taking screenshots. So yes, this is the little guest house / young adult house that I created. I feel like it's more for young adult, like I said before, rather than a guest house, because you can't really properly use guest houses in Sims 4, at least not yet. Hopefully one day you can, unless you play with mods. But like, whenever I say you can't use this for that because it doesn't work, I don't play with mods myself, and I think most people don't. So that's why I prefer to just keep it, you know, playable for a person that doesn't play with mods. That's also why I don't build with CC. First of all, I don't really want build CC in my game, because I feel like if you build a house partly with CC, it doesn't really look like it fits in completely. I know there's not a lot of Maxis Match furniture, but still, I just feel like it looks a little bit out of place, and you need to like have a whole house filled with CC before that works. So that's just my personal opinion, but also personally I also think that it's easier to put CC in, like exchange a chair with a CC chair, rather than downloading a house that was full with CC, and then when you downloaded it, it just turned empty and you don't know where everything goes, unless you want to furnish the whole house yourself as well. That's fine, I know a lot of people do that too, but that's just, I feel like it's easier to do that, so I prefer to not build with CC, and also for mainly with people in mind that don't use mods, basically. But I get a lot of those comments like, well, you know, you can get this mods for that or for that or for that, and I'm like, I just prefer to build without mods in mind, basically. But as you can see, we are furnishing the bedroom in this little guest house / extra house, small house. I don't actually know what that's called when it's not a guest house, but a young adult lives in it. I think it's more like a renovated garage or something, or something else. I don't fully know. But it's somewhat a guest house, but not really, because it's for a specific sim. It's very personalized in my opinion, which is why I feel like it's more for a personal or for a specific sim rather than a guest house, you know what I mean? Because there's a lot of like clutter in here, and they have their own computer and decor and all that stuff. So definitely more for a specific sim rather than a guest house, at least in my mind, but I will let you guys decide for yourselves. And other than that, we are getting to the end of this video, so I'm gonna wrap up this voiceover now. There will be a whole lot of screenshots after my little outro, so if you're interested in watching those, do hang around and watch till the end. There's like 50 plus screenshots or something. I went a little bit crazy, sorry about that. But also, come back tomorrow around 4 p.m. or at least keep an eye on the channel after 4 p.m. tomorrow if you want to see some early access stuff, like I said before, because there will be a lot of that on YouTube tomorrow, so definitely come back and check those out, and also Thursday. And yeah, other than that, I hope you guys like this build. You can download it off the gallery. My ID is EvelynYT, and you can also find it under the hashtag Evelyn or EvelynYT. As always, if you got any suggestions, do leave a comment in the comment section down below. I am always up for suggestions, especially if you got something surrounding the new expansion pack. I would definitely be up for hearing you out on that. And other than that, I hope you enjoyed this video. Remember to like, subscribe, and all that good stuff if you did. And I will see you all in the next one. Bye-bye!